There are several things that you can do in Audacity to improve your voice recording. We'll be showing you how to use the following tools. Use our clickable sections below to keep track of what step you're on during this tutorial. Be careful when using our suggested effects. Overdoing these can cause your voice to become too boomy or grating. First, let's add some fullness and presence to your voice using two different EQ methods in Audacity. In order to process your audio files using the methods described, double-click your audio file to select the section that you want to clean up. We'll start with Audacity's Bass and Treble effect. It's a quick way to add some presence to your voice recording. Go into the Effect menu and select Bass and Treble. Try increasing both the bass and the treble just a bit to increase your volume level, no more than 2 to 3 dB. Click Start Playback to hear your effect. And when you're satisfied, click Apply. Another method is using Audacity's Filter Curve EQ. This will give you more nuanced control over the frequencies in your recording. Make sure your audio is still selected, then go into the Effect menu and select Filter Curve. The Filter Curve EQ allows you to select a frequency range so that you can make more granular adjustments based on your preference. Click on the graph to insert points at the frequencies you wish to adjust. For the low end, let's start somewhere between 100 to 230 Hz. Insert your points, and then drag them up or down to adjust the gain of that frequency range. Don't add more than a couple of decibels, or it will sound too boomy. Click on the preview button to test your effect. It may take a second or more for Audacity to pre-render the effect, depending upon the length of your audio. For the high end, do the same for the upper frequencies. Try starting around 2.5 kHz and bringing that up just a bit. Again, your adjustment should not be above 3 decibels at the most. Once you're satisfied, click OK. Another method of improving voice quality is to use a compressor. This type of processor helps even out the differences in amplitude over the length of your recording. Select your audio file, go into the Effects menu and select Compressor. Set the threshold to about minus 30 decibels. Set the noise floor to about minus 50 decibels. The ratio should be set to about 2 to 1 to 3 to 1 or so, higher if you really want that in-your-face radio voice. The attack and release should both be set to very short times. And finally, make sure that the makeup gain for 0 dB after compressing option is selected. Again, you can preview the effect to make sure you are satisfied with the changes. Then click OK. The final thing you can do to bring out your voice is to normalize it. This is a process that brings your recording up to its fullest potential without adding distortion. Make sure your audio is selected, go into the Effects menu, and click on Normalize. Ensure that both the Remove DC Offset and Normalize Peak Amplitude 2 options are selected. Set the Normalize Peak Amplitude 2 setting to about minus 1 dB. You can preview this to hear it, and then click OK.